kitchen with Sam. So Sam, what are you going to whip up for us today?
Well, I'm going to do a really light style, seasonal, sort of more like a summer salad today of Brussels sprouts. Now, most people are scared of Brussels sprouts. They were overfed them as a child often. Yep. Your mothers used to cook them when they turn, until they turn grey. And it's usually the smell that deters them. And what that smell is actually the sulphur that's coming out of them. So the sulphur is really good for you because it helps to detoxify the liver. But you don't want to have your Brussels sprouts overcooked. So we're going to do a living kind of salad today, you know, using raw ingredients and bringing out the best qualities. So the way that I shave the Brussels sprouts, it's kind of interesting. You need a little paddle like this, which is called a mandolin. And if you don't have one of these, you can use the side of your normal cheese grater.
Oh, cool.
You know, on the side of that grater, there's one blade. You have to be really careful that you don't cut your fingers. So I've already started a few. And what I've done is I just hold the base of the Brussels sprout here and then carefully, finally slice it. So it starts to shred. It's like a slaw, a Brussels sprout slaw.
Yeah, it is. What else are Brussels sprouts good for? Why should we be eating them?
Well, they're from the Brassicaceae family, and those relatives are cauliflower and cabbage and broccoli and broccolini as well. And they help to, as I say, to detoxify the liver because of the sulphurous compound, but they also help to purify the blood. And they're like mini cabbages as well. I think they're really beautiful. I reckon they're really cute, you know. They're gorgeous. They're like a cabbage in the palm kind of thing. So, again, it's alkalinity and liver detox, or liver cleansing, I should say.
That's what we all really need.
It's what everybody seems to want. Yeah. It's kind of like the buzzwords. Yeah. And then I've got some cucumber, which I've done exactly the same thing. Now, you can peel the cucumbers if you want to. Preferably, you've got organic produce where you want to have the best nutrients in the skin, all the nutrients from the skin. But if you're using conventional, you couldn't get your organic, then give them a bit of a peel.
Yeah. And
just shave it down.
Skin as well, don't they? So it is always best to get organic.
Yeah, that's right, because the thinner the skin and the greater the surface area, again, it absorbs a lot more chemicals. So from there, we can add some other sprouts. I've got mung bean sprouts and I've got a dookie bean sprouts. And there's a few lentil sprouts in there. So it's super healthy, super duper healthy. And the sprouts are really important because they're packed full of enzymes. So they really help to kickstart and repair a lot of our DNA in the body. Now you can use your hand or you can just give that a little bit of a toss without dressing at this stage, just to combine. And then we want to add a little bit of protein for this, so it could be a great vegetarian option.
Yeah.
So I've got some activated almonds here and I'm just slicing them lengthwise in half. Yep. So that obviously creates a larger surface area, so when we add a dressing, it absorbs the flavour a lot more.
And so tell us, what does it mean by activated? Because that's a bit of a buzzword as well.
Yeah, it is, isn't it? So we activate them, we soak them overnight. These are insecticide-free almonds. They're on their way, they're in conversion to organic, the ones I'm using at the moment. We soak them and then we put them in a very slow oven called a dehydrator and we roast that at about 43 degrees Celsius or 104 Fahrenheit, or thereabouts anyway, for about 48 hours. And so what that does, as they're soaking, that brings out a little renaissance in the enzymes. The enzyme activity starts to kickstart in the nut, rebirth, and then we captivate that enzyme by drying it slowly.
Awesome.
So what you find is you've got a much crunchier nut, but more importantly, it's packed full of goodness
again.
Yeah, yeah, super nuts. They're alive, they're living foods. And that's what we look at. If you just chop these nuts, I'll try not to chop off my finger, then you don't get the surface area, and it's really important that you get that surface area because that adds a flavour, which is why the Chinese often have, you know, in their conventional dishes, their chicken and almonds kind of thing, they'll always have the slithered or the flaked almond because of that. Just one more. Again, this salad you could have with an animal protein, a beautiful piece of fish would be lovely. We're going to make a little dressing just out of sherry vinegar and macadamia nut oil, just to give a piquancy. So the vinegar helps to lift the Brussels sprouts, otherwise they can be a bit too meaty.
Yeah.
That's kind of the description of Brussels sprouts and cabbage. They have meaty qualities. They do. They're winter vegetables, but they lend themselves well to the warmer months as well.
Yeah, it looks very refreshing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And juice of a lime. A fork here somewhere. So you can just squeeze that out. Use a fork or use a citrus juicer, obviously. So we've got the acidity. Obviously, we've got vitamin C and all the bioflavonoids that are coming out of the pith as I do this. But the sour flavour is really important. So in Chinese medicine, we describe the Brussels sprouts as being pungent.
Yeah.
And then you balance that with the sour flavour. And you can add a lot more dressing to this, but this will just give us a little bit of a lift. And then we'll just give that a little bit of a toss through. Could add a whole lot of other nuts and seeds. We've got some pepitas over there we can garnish it with.
That looks amazing. Then,
yeah, it comes up well, doesn't it?
Yeah.
And then I've got some beautiful chard, again belonging to the spinach family, and it has a beautiful red line through it, which we can just put a few leaves through just to lift it as well. You could add any kind of creamy dressing you want, and then we can just pop it on the plate with some radicchio and some other leaves and just gently spoon it, because it's always about the presentation.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't need too much. Just gently put it through a little plate like that, and you'll be surprised how delicious it is.
It looks pretty impressive too, yeah, for something so simple, and for Brussels sprouts.
Yeah, we've converted many a Brussels sprout hater, and yeah, I'm never going to eat Brussels sprouts. And then the little pesto resistance is a little prune dressing.
Ooh,
so some pureed prunes, which are very good for your tummy, we know yes, that. And just a little bit of lime and lemon juice, just to give it a bit of sweetness, to balance some of the sour flavour from the lime,
yeah,
and the pungent flavour. So that'll just lift the sweetness, and just to decorate with a few little pepitas. And just a couple of edible flowers.
That looks gorgeous.
To finish it. So really fresh, green, a little bit of sweetness, a bit of acidity through the Brussels sprouts, and the pungent energy to help to cleanse the liver and detox the blood. Would
Yum.
You like to try?
Yes, absolutely.
There you go.
Thank you. Get a bit of this in there.
Get a bit of that in there, yep, absolutely.
And the sprouts.
Good?
Yeah, best Brussels sprouts I've ever eaten. That's amazing.
Yeah, they're good, aren't
that
they?
Sauce
it's
is incredible.
Really, it really yeah, gives it a lift.
You are going to love this recipe. I totally recommend that you go and try it tonight.
Guarantee you'll yeah, be converted yeah, back to Brussels sprouts. Mm.